Try not to become a man of success, but rather try to become a man of value. In the vast history of human thought, there are only a few names that shine like eternal stars. Among them, one man stands out as both a scientist and a philosopher, a dreamer who bent the fabric of reality itself, Albert Einstein. The boy who was once considered slow, the young man dismissed by teachers, the outsider who struggled to find a job, would later redefine the very laws of nature. From the theory of relativity to the photoelectric effect, from Nobel Prizes to global fame, his journey is not just the story of equations. It is the story of imagination, courage, and an unshakable belief in the mysteries of the universe. But who was Einstein beyond the formulas? What shaped his mind, his passions, and his philosophy of life? And how did one man's ideas forever change the destiny of humanity? In this episode of The Lost Journal, we open the pages of history to explore the life of Albert Einstein, the man who taught us to see the universe with new eyes. So sit back, take a deep breath, and join us as we journey through the mind of a genius. Albert Einstein was born on March 14, 1879, in the small German city of Ulm. His family was not wealthy nor aristocratic, but ordinary middle-class people trying to make a living. From the very beginning, Albert's life carried an unusual note. At birth, his head was oddly shaped, and his parents worried about his future health. Doctors assured them that he would grow normally, and indeed, within weeks, his head returned to a normal shape. But the sense that Albert was somehow different never quite left. As a child, he was slow to speak. In fact, he did not begin speaking fluently until the age of 4. His parents feared he might have a developmental problem, and his teachers later described him as distant, distracted, and difficult. Yet in those quiet years of silence, something extraordinary was happening inside him. Albert developed a habit of thinking in images rather than words. He would visualize complex ideas, turning them into vivid mental pictures. This unusual way of thinking would later become the foundation of his greatest discoveries. The Einstein family moved frequently in search of work. When Albert was just a year old, they relocated to Munich, where his father, Hermann, and his uncle ran an electrical engineering company. The young boy grew up surrounded by wires, batteries, and machines, objects that sparked his curiosity about the hidden forces of nature. One of the earliest stories told about him reveals the spark of his genius. At the age of 5, Albert fell ill and was confined to bed. To comfort him, his father gave him a simple magnetic compass. Albert was mesmerized. No matter how he turned it, the needle always pointed north. He realized that something invisible, some unseen force, was guiding the needle. This mystery, that the universe held hidden laws beyond what the eye could see, captured his imagination forever. School, however, was not kind to him. Albert hated the rigid discipline of the German education system. Teachers expected obedience and memorization, while he preferred curiosity and freedom. One teacher famously told him, "You will never amount to anything." Yet Albert's curiosity did not fade. Instead, he found joy in music. His mother, Pauline, introduced him to the violin, and Albert would spend hours playing Mozart. Music became his refuge, a way to express feelings and ideas that words could not capture. By the time he was a teenager, Einstein's mind was already restless. He devoured books on mathematics and philosophy, far beyond the level of his classmates. And yet, his school reports remained poor, reinforcing the belief that he was a failure. But hidden beneath the label of slow student was a young man whose imagination was quietly preparing to change the world. As Albert grew older, his rebellious spirit only deepened. In Munich, he clashed with teachers who valued discipline over curiosity. He despised rote memorization and strict classroom rules. At just 15 years old, he walked out of school, declaring he would never return. The Einstein family had already fallen on hard times. His father's electrical business collapsed, and the family moved to Italy in search of new opportunities. Albert, restless and disillusioned, joined them, but his education was now uncertain. It was in Switzerland that his life took a new direction. At 16, he applied to the Swiss Federal Polytechnic in Zurich, a prestigious technical school. But when he sat for the entrance exam, he failed in several subjects, especially language and history. Only his brilliant performance in mathematics and physics saved him. The professors saw his raw talent and allowed him to enroll in a preparatory program. 1 year later, he passed the exam and was admitted as a student of mathematics and physics. Here, he would finally find a place that valued independent thought. Still, Einstein was not the model student. He often skipped lectures, preferring to study on his own. He clashed with professors who considered him arrogant and undisciplined. One professor even refused to recommend him for academic jobs, declaring, "He will never make it in physics." Despite this, Einstein found joy in studying the works of great scientists and philosophers. He devoured Maxwell's theories of electromagnetism, Newton's mechanics, and Kant's philosophy. But above all, he nurtured his own way of thinking, thought experiments. Einstein would imagine himself chasing beams of light, riding alongside them through space. He asked, "What would I see if I moved at the speed of light?" These mental experiments, dismissed by others as childish fantasies, became the seeds of revolutionary science. Yet when he graduated in 1900, Einstein's struggles had only just begun. Unlike his classmates, who quickly secured teaching posts, Einstein found himself unemployed. For 2 years, he searched desperately for a position. He even considered giving up physics entirely. But fate had other plans. In 1902, with the help of a friend, he secured a modest job at the Swiss Patent Office in Bern. Here, his task was to review applications for new inventions. It was far from the life of a professor, but it gave him something precious: stability, free evenings, and endless time to think. Einstein later joked that the patent office was his worldly monastery, a quiet place where his imagination could roam freely. And it was here, in this unremarkable office, that the young man dismissed as a failure began to prepare for his greatest triumphs. In 1905, inside the quiet walls of the Swiss Patent Office, Albert Einstein changed the world forever. Historians call it the Annus Mirabilis, the miracle year. In the span of just 12 months, Einstein published 4 scientific papers that shattered the foundations of physics. The first paper explained the mysterious phenomenon of the photoelectric effect. Light, he argued, was not just a wave, but came in tiny packets of energy, quanta. This bold idea laid the groundwork for quantum mechanics, a field that would dominate the 20th century. For this discovery, he would later receive the Nobel Prize. The second paper proved the existence of atoms. While many scientists still debated whether atoms were real, Einstein used mathematics to describe how tiny particles move randomly in liquids, a phenomenon known as Brownian motion. His calculations gave irrefutable evidence. Atoms were not just theory, but reality. The third paper introduced his special theory of relativity. It began with a simple but profound question: what are the laws of physics when objects move at constant speeds? Einstein's answer was revolutionary. He showed that space and time were not absolute, but woven together into a single fabric: space-time. Time itself could stretch or shrink depending on how fast you move. The universe, he revealed, was far stranger than anyone had imagined. And then, in his fourth paper, he delivered one of the most famous equations in human history, E equals mc squared. Energy equals mass times the speed of light squared. With this formula, Einstein revealed that matter and energy were two sides of the same coin. Even a tiny amount of matter could unleash unimaginable energy, a truth that would one day change the world in both miraculous and terrifying ways. Einstein was only 26 years old. He was not a professor, not a celebrated scholar, but a clerk in a patent office. And yet, in 1 year, he had transformed physics more than most scientists do in a lifetime. Word of his genius began to spread. Leading universities and physicists took notice. By 1909, he was finally offered a professorship. The young man once dismissed as a failure was now being hailed as one of the greatest minds alive. But Einstein himself remained humble. He often said, "I have no special talent. I am only passionately curious." And it was this relentless curiosity that drove him forward into new mysteries of the cosmos. By 1915, Einstein had been working tirelessly for a decade to expand his ideas on relativity. Special relativity explained motion at constant speeds, but what about acceleration and gravity? For years, Einstein wrestled with equations that seemed impossible to solve. At one point, he even admitted to close friends, "In my life, I have never struggled so hard." And then, after nights of relentless calculation, he succeeded. In November 1915, Einstein presented the general theory of relativity to the Prussian Academy of Sciences. His theory was breathtaking. Gravity was not an invisible force pulling objects together, as Newton had described. Instead, mass and energy curved the very fabric of space and time, and objects moved along those curves. The universe itself was not a static stage, but a dynamic, flexible fabric. Yet theory alone was not enough. For Einstein's ideas to be accepted, they needed proof. That proof came in 1919. During a solar eclipse, British astronomer Sir Arthur Eddington set out to test Einstein's predictions. If general relativity was correct, the light from distant stars passing near the sun would bend, not because of the sun's pull, but because space itself was curved. When the results were announced, the headlines shook the world. "Einstein theory triumphs," declared the Times of London. Overnight, Albert Einstein became a global celebrity. For the first time in history, a theoretical physicist had reached the fame of a rock star. But fame came with a price. Einstein was suddenly thrust into the spotlight, his face on newspapers, his name on everyone's lips. He was celebrated as a genius, but also criticized, envied, and misunderstood. He once wrote, "To punish me for my contempt of authority, fate made me an authority myself." As Europe plunged into war and turmoil, Einstein used his platform not for glory, but for peace. He spoke out against militarism, nationalism, and hatred. He advocated for international cooperation and disarmament at a time when the world seemed headed in the opposite direction. Yet even as he rose to fame, Einstein remained the same curious soul who once gazed at a compass needle as a boy. He continued to push the boundaries of science, chasing after a unified theory that could combine gravity with quantum mechanics. Though he never solved it, he never gave up. General relativity not only transformed science, it transformed our place in the universe. It revealed black holes, the expansion of the cosmos, the very concept of the Big Bang. And at the heart of it all stood a man who often said he wanted to understand the thoughts of God. Einstein's work was no longer just about equations. It was about humanity itself and the future of our world. In the 1930s, dark clouds were gathering over Europe. The rise of Adolf Hitler and the Nazi regime marked a terrifying era. For Albert Einstein, who was Jewish, Germany was no longer safe. In 1933, as Hitler came to power, Einstein was abroad in the United States, giving lectures. He never returned to his homeland. The Nazis burned his books, vilified his name, and placed a price on his head. But Einstein refused to be silenced. He settled in Princeton, New Jersey, where he joined the newly established Institute for Advanced Study. There, he would spend the rest of his life, walking the same quiet paths, hair unkempt, pipe in hand, lost in thought. To the world, he became the image of the modern genius. Eccentric, gentle, and deeply human. Yet his mind never stopped. As World War II erupted, Einstein was deeply troubled. Though he was a lifelong pacifist, he feared that Nazi Germany might develop nuclear weapons. In 1939, he co-signed a letter to President Franklin D. Roosevelt, warning of this possibility. That letter helped launch the Manhattan Project, the secret American effort to build the atomic bomb. But when Hiroshima and Nagasaki were destroyed in 1945, Einstein was devastated. He later said, "Had I known they would do this, I would have never signed the letter." From that moment, he dedicated his life to peace activism, nuclear disarmament, and global cooperation. In his later years, Einstein continued searching for a unified theory of physics. Though he never achieved it, he never lost his childlike curiosity. He played violin, welcomed students, and spoke passionately about justice, freedom, and human dignity. Einstein died in 1955 at the age of 76. Doctors offered to preserve his brain for study, hoping to unlock the secrets of genius. But perhaps the real secret was not in the folds of his brain, but in the fire of his imagination. Today, Einstein's face is everywhere, on posters, t-shirts, and murals. But his true legacy is far greater. It is in the GPS systems that use relativity to guide us, the black holes studied by astronomers, the expansion of the universe mapped by cosmologists. It is in every child who dares to ask, why? Albert Einstein once said, "Imagination is more important than knowledge. For knowledge is limited, but imagination encircles the world." Albert Einstein was more than just a scientist. He was a visionary who changed not only how we see the universe, but also how we see ourselves. From a boy with a strange-shaped head in Ulm, to a Nobel laureate whose equations shook the very foundations of physics, Einstein's story reminds us that genius is not only about intelligence, it is about imagination, courage, and perseverance. Even today, his theories continue to guide spacecraft across the cosmos, shape the technologies in our pockets, and challenge philosophers to rethink the very nature of reality. So when we look up at the night sky, let us remember, Einstein showed us that the universe is not a cold, silent void, but a place full of mystery, wonder, and endless discovery. Thank you for watching this journey into the life of Albert Einstein. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share your thoughts in the comments. Your support helps us uncover more hidden stories of history and science. And as the Lost Journal closes this chapter, we are reminded, every discovery is a doorway. Every question is a journey. And remember, every story leaves a trace.